Hello, my name is Jimmy Allison. I'm an Ableton Live certified trainer at Austin Ableton Tutor, and my stage name is Rentac. Building custom drum racks in Push 2 in Ableton Live 9.5 or later is a whole new level of workflow. In this video, I'm going to show you how to chop an amen break to make a jungle style rhythm. Here's a link to download the amen break if you'd like to follow along. Using Push 2, click the Add Device button, and then you can use the arrow buttons to navigate to your user files. Any folders that you have added to Places will be available under User Files. I'm going to navigate to my Samples folder, Breaks, Classic Breaks, which is where my Amen Break is located. You can hear a preview of the sample whenever you select an audio file with Push 2 if the preview button is enabled in your live file browser. With the Amen Break selected, press Load, then the sample will load into a sampler on a new MIDI track. With Live 9.5, Sampler has undergone a major update. Sampler now has three modes. Classic mode, which works much like the old sampler, except you can apply warping to the sample in Sampler. This means we can now transpose the sample with the keys and the tempo of the sample will not change. Now change the mode of Sampler on the Push to one-shot mode. In one-shot mode, by default, all you have to do is press the key and the sample will play till the end one time. But we will be focusing on slice mode. Switching into slice mode automatically chops up the sample based on transient detection. You can adjust the sensitivity to decrease the number of slices. You can also manually enter slices by enabling pad slicing. Then all you have to do is hit a pad to add a slice. Using the nudge, you can adjust the start point of each slice that is selected. I'm going to delete all my slices and increase the sensitivity so I have 8 pads selected. Push 2 has a new button called Convert. Pressing this button will bring up an option to convert Sampler to drum rack. Now the slices are loaded to 8 cells of a drum rack. And notice that each slice is actually a Sampler set to one-shot mode. You can use Fade In and Fade Out to clean up the slices. You can also adjust the start and end of each slice as needed. Using the fades and adjusting the start and end of each slice is how you can dial in the samples and get rid of the non-zero crossing clicks. Now the slices are nice and clean, and you can have a lot of fun playing the break by jamming on the pads. You can turn on the metronome and use the pads to play in an idea. Or you could use the drum rack sequencer on the Push and sequence in an idea. Now let's get a little deeper into drum rack editing with Push 2. To copy-paste a cell, hold down Duplicate, tap the pad you want to copy, and then tap the pad where you want the cell to load into. To delete a cell, hold down Delete and tap the pad. I copied the snare hit because I want to repitch the snare. First, I will shorten the slice so it is only the snare by adjusting the end, and then I will pitch up the snare using the transpose. In the next slice, I want to tweak it a bit further using the sampler. I will copy and paste the snare to a blank cell by holding down Duplicate. Now if I double press the button that says Slice 3, that will get me into the chain. I can then press on Sampler, which will give me full access to all the parameters in Sampler. Then by selecting Warp, I can modify the warp mode. I would like to slow down the sample to give it a stretch effect. By clicking the times 2 button, Sampler will multiply the BPM by 2. Since we are not changing the global tempo to match the sample, we will be playing the sample at half speed, which will give me the stretched out effect. I'm going to shorten the slice so the cell only plays the snare, and then try different warp modes and warp mode settings to get a cool sound. I can dig that. Now click on main to get back to the main sampler controls, adjust the fade out and transpose. Now I'm going to create a repeating pitch down effect. In the main sample view, I can change the sampler to classic mode. Then adjust the length to give a nice looping repeat. Next, select envelopes. Turn the knob to select the pitch envelope. Make sure the pitch envelope is on, and then make some adjustments to get the desired effect. Adjusting the envelope amount will set how much the envelope affects the pitch. and using the ADSR envelope, we'll dial in the effect. This is just a taste of what can be done with Ableton Live and Push 2. Explore, have fun, and feel free to check out some of my other videos. Thank you for watching, and I hope you found this video very helpful. I'm available for private lessons and classes online and in the Austin, Texas area. Feel free to contact me for more information and check out my website, austinabletontutor.com. Also, check out my other videos and like Austin Ableton Tutor on Facebook.